All right, back into the paved stuff. National Series was at a road course last week, so took that off, and now we are at Atlanta. 1.5 mile track. We will see if I can keep the right front on it. It's been my biggest issue on these 1.5 mile tracks is just burning off the right front compared to everyone else. So we got 30 laps, starting 10th as the number 10 car. And I hope I can just put something together. See how it goes though. Just hit 1,000 subscribers, so thank you everyone who has subscribed. If you haven't, it'll help me out. But thanks to the people that have newly subscribed and the ones that have been around since way back in the beginning. Alright, top side's going a little slow. Had to check up there, otherwise I was going to run over to 16. Going to get trapped up here. It's okay though, we can make it work while we're still coming up to speed. Go ahead and cut down now, out of the corner, get around the 16 car. Little lift, because I can't go anywhere anyways. Gonna be three wide for a second. One's in the wall right as I looked. So yeah, not a whole lot to do in this. You just kind of ease it in. Get to the white line. One and two, I get to it late. Three and four, I kind of hug the white line all the way around. Backing off just because this guy's right up the tailpipe of the five, or the seven, sorry. And then he really pushed up in the middle of the corner. We're going to go ahead and get under him, even though he's going to block it. Drive to the center, push up. Never understood people blocking when they're clearly going to get passed. Goodbye, number 13. He might come back on with them. Go a little wider in. Prevent him from turning down like he wants right away. Get a little loose there. Now he's going to try to do a dive bomb because he thinks that I did that to him. I'm just going to drive it in hard. A little lift in the center and pull away. Driving the car just a little bit right now, just to pull away from this guy. No cautions in this series, so it's a full 35 laps. Do what you can do. Try to catch up to the back of the seven and then just kind of hang there. Five cars probably a little quicker. 13's gonna once again slow himself down by trying to pass someone that just passed him. Could have just fell in, but oh well, not my issue. Not anymore. Car's feeling pretty good right now. Haven't had much practice. My real life racing injuries are catching up to me again, so my spine and the nerves down into my legs are all screwed up today. It's been creeping up on me for the last couple of weeks. Does this every 2 years. The good thing about sim racing, I don't think I can hurt my back any worse. Never will get a motion rig, obviously. So five cars catching us. When he gets here, we'll let him go. Just tag on to the back of him. Looks like six car might be struggling just a bit ahead of the seven. Not sure. Might just be taking it easy too. So hitting the line gets a little harder right when you're up on someone's spoiler. Just gotta look ahead. Don't ever get focused on the back of another car. Kinda corner of the eye, looking at him. Alright, this guy's slowing me down. We need to always get around him. Catch him in all the wrong spots right there, and I clipped the apron just a little bit. Let's push up. Luckily, five car had a little issue too. Not turn in for me there. We might lose a few spots here. Good arc in the turn. Need to just get a decent run off the corner on him. Into the corner a little shallower. Right on the white line. Two cars coming. Hopefully he can be patient enough to wait till 3 and 4. Push in the center. Go. Please go. And we'll lift off full entry ton and cut back down, rather than staying side by side with him. All it does is just waste time off the corner for both of us. The faster he gets by, the faster I can get going again. And he might open the door for this six car if I can catch back up in time. There and got a bad push. That's gonna kill some time. All right, go ahead, go five. Get both these guys by me and just settle in. Still got half a race to go. Can't pick that right front, and I started to do so by trying to keep up with the two. It was right about the time where I struggle, although the car really struggled there. Screw it. I'll get him back. I pushed it so bad. I almost wrecked all three of us. And he just sat on my fucking fender and almost turned us both. That issue. Had he not fucked up passing the 5 car, he wouldn't have been in that situation, but he did. It allowed me to get under both of them, and then he decided to try to race it by not giving me any room whatsoever. Right front's fucked. Can't even go up high. I don't know what I do wrong here. Every mile and a half, I am just dead on these new tires. Me and the 5 keep slowing each other down, letting each other go, pass. Now we're back here with the 14 and the 16, who've probably been saving their tires up pretty well. And then here comes the 12, who seems to be hauling too. All my fault though, I've entered too deep and pushed up and totally killed my shit. 12's got extremely good speed, so just gonna let him go. Pointless to fight it. He's gonna blow past these guys and work his way up to the front. I just need to try a race, I guess, where I don't go very hard and see if it helps at the end. And he's onto the throttle instead of flat-footing it there. Come on, guys, quit fucking up. Little apron touch. Got a lift. It's a hell of a lot better than eating the wall. Might lose a second, but now he's all the way back, 2.5 seconds. Thought 12 car was gonna pull away quicker, but he struggled quite a bit around the 16. So now that he's got clean air, he might be able to suck up to the 5 quick. Car up ahead got a little loose on exit, it looked like. Really rolling in slow. Waiting till it wants to turn before I get on the gas, instead of using the gas to turn it. And going backwards. I gotta figure something out. This is just pathetic. I don't like being this slow. 6, 7 laps left. Looking like an 11th place finish. Very surprised by the 12 car. I figured he was just going to be flying by us. So the middle of 1 and 2 felt halfway decent. Not really middle, but one groove up. Kind of right there. I guess that's almost half a groove. Got on it too hard. That just took a little more life out of the right front. Try to go 3 and 4, see what happens. Last lap and see if I can find any speed. I'm guessing it's all just go a little slower around the bottom and that'll still be quickest. These two can get to fight. But even if I get to them, I don't think I'm going to have the maneuverability to get around them. Oh, he put it in the wall, which is very easy to do on the outside on entry to 3. Just kind of juts out there. It's a weird, weird angle. It's been around since this place was even an oval. I've seen peak drivers and pro drivers do that. It's just, if you watch it, you can see, like, bends back in. He does it again. Alright, gifted 10th place. But yeah, you can see how it doesn't really arc like the rest of the corner until right about the 3 on Atlanta 3. And then it just does a normal arc. But seen many people do what the 12 did. Well, unfortunately, that was fairly boring at the end. Get 12th, or 10th, sorry. But that's where I was predicted to finish. And that's essentially where I started, so we'll take it. Let's go take a quick look at the incidents with me and the 8 car. See if we got any nasty messages. So it's easier to watch it from here. So this is where he totally fucks up the pass. Pushes them both up. So I had a massive run. And then I go in here and totally fuck up the pass. Push up too much. he just starts wanting to wreck himself. See, he just sits on my quarter panel. We come together there. Like, that's not necessary. That is not needed. You don't have to be that close, and you're never going to make a pass around the outside. So, he does it again. Getting too close. So, easy way to solve that is a late turn-in. He came down, ran into me, put himself in the wall. Just, all he had to do was drop back behind the five and then pass me again. He was clearly quicker, but whatever. Start running me like that, and I'm going to start using up a lot more track just to prevent myself from getting turned. So, well, I hope you enjoyed that one. No anger, so that's good. Still, Jesus, 53%, 81%. That is not good. Take a quick look at the results. And gained 17, gained some iRating, or some safety rating, had zero incidents. Although we essentially had an incident there. But yeah, not good enough for me. So, hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching.